Hi, I'm Damien and welcome to 1833. Yeah, so what's good, So, you're looking at you saying two bottles of your two, or see two boxes of rum, you're thinking, why have you got two? Well, remember a few weeks ago, maybe I should have checked this before I come on the program, but maybe three reviews ago, I reviewed a HMS Princessa, and I had it down, I gave it top marks, buy and keep. Because it was just the best rum I've had in a long time. So I saw the Royal Oak available as well. There's actually another in this series, another one as well. So I may get and review that. So we've got the HMS Royal Oak today. We've had the Princessa with the Royal Oak today. So we're going to see if the Royal Oak can live up to the standing that Princessa had. Because this got, like I said, got top score. So I'm going to read the blurb at the back to tell you what the Royal Oak was. And for those who have watched the early episodes of what the first like two, three reviews, you remember I just gave that little history lesson about history of rum, where it came from, that sort of thing. So I do enjoy these boxes because they're named after real ships, and it gives it a little paragraph as to what the ship was and what the ship accomplished. So the HMS Royal Oak was in the vanguard of ships to engage your friends in the famous Battle of the Saints. So the vanguard, if you don't know, vanguard is at the forefront. The it would have been the lead of the first batch of ships that took part in this sea battle. So vanguard means the early ones, the forward row. So vanguard of ships to engage the French in the famous Battle of the Saints. The Saints, again, this would have been a battle of in the Caribbean between the Brits and the French. And you know, you have the islands in the Caribbean, St. Kitts, St. Vincent, St. Lucia, so on and so forth. This particular ship, the Royal Oak, was captained by Thomas Burnett. The Royal Oak maneuvered skillfully and brought to bear all of her 74 guns on the enemy for the duration of the battle. With 8 men lost and 20 wounded, Royal Oak played an integral role in the first skirmishes of the battle and encouraged us to create a rum of rarity, intensity, and boldness. Okay, so that's the Royal Oak. Another gorgeous bottle, just like the Princessa bottle. In fact, let's get it out so you can see that what it looks like as well. So the bottle is pretty much exactly the same. It's got a... The bottle reminds me of a Diplomatico as well, actually, I'm going to lie to you. So there's the Princessa. Here is the Royal Oak. And you know it's got my favourite kind of lid on it as well, right? You know that to go... So let's get the light by the way. Let's bring this closer to the mic. Let's see if we can pick this up. Oh, that was a damn squib. Let's try that. We've been in my closet. Let's try that again. There we go. One more time. Yeah, that is the sound we like to hear. All right, put that mic back. Sorry for any interference here and there. All right, so. It smells like a brandy. Okay. So again, once more, the Admiral Rodney rums are from St. Lucia. So St. Lucia get another representation again very soon, you know. But the last rum I reviewed was a Cuban rum. And before that, we had a St. Vincent rum. So, you know, we're going to islands, but we have done St. Lucia twice in recent history. So unless I get the third in this... this trilogy or in this promotion or whatever the word they want to use, we won't go to St. Lucia for a while. Just, you know, I might get a third one and then that's it for St. Lucia for a little while, because I've been there for a while. In fact, I may go back to maybe Jamaica or Fiji, Barbados for the next rum. We're going Barbados for the next rum. Yeah, Watch your space. I've got the rum here. Another rum I'm getting as well. Oh, I'm getting. Ooh. I get it tomorrow, or I'll reserve it and get it next week. But I'm getting, I know what I'm getting, just to make sure it's there for me. It's released today, actually, so I'm going to make it. I'm not going down there today. I'll try tomorrow. Okay, so this smells pretty strong. So, lovely colour, firstly, nice deep brown. No legs. Any legs in this? Not the best glass, but to see legs, there are some. Yeah, there are some. Not as leggy as think some things I drink had recently. The Emmente had really long legs. That has a Cuban rum. So this has some, but not as much as the Emmente 7 year old. The smell, smell the alcohol immediately. Smell a little bit of smell of sugar, the smell of brown sugar. Smell a little bit of cocoa in there as well. I'd even say perhaps a little bit of honey. It might be wrong, it might be off on the honey, but this is, the sweet smell is definitely sugar. I'm assuming it's brown sugar. Maybe a hint of honey. I could be off. Now, who's a pro out here? Right, let's go. Interesting. So, this is smooth, goes on nicely, it's not, but there's a little bit of a, say a bitter aftertaste. So what, after the initial flavor's gone, there's a bit of a tart, bittery. Yeah, not tart, bitter. Bitter's work, right, yeah. Little bit of a bitter aftertaste. It sort of lingers in the mouth a little bit. It's not what you get, it's not the initial hit, but it's what comes after and what hangs around. But it is smooth. Sweet enough. Sweet enough. Sweet enough that, again, it's not, I wouldn't call it a sweet rum. A sweet enough that you can just sip it on its own, if that's lime, ice, whatever. You don't need to add anything to it. It's definitely a good sipping rum. Flavor-wise, though, apart from it being smooth and that bitter aftertaste, see, nothing's really jumping out at me in this one. I'm not saying it's a bland rum, but I'm not getting any the feel from this. So I'm not picking up the tobacco. And perhaps there is a little bit of vanilla there, but I've had more vanilla in other rums, so it was a bit more identifiable. Perhaps the way it's been blended, nothing really pops out, but yeah, I'm not getting the earthy feel, so I'm not really agreeing with the tobacco. Yeah, no. It's a difficult one, because for me, there's no discerning flavor. There's no flavor that, say, jumps out and says, oh, here I am. We've had that before in the past, you know? We've definitely had that before in the past. But it's a good rum. Although I'm finding it difficult to sort of give you, good feedback of the flavors and what's coming through, that doesn't say it's not a good rum. It's a good tasting rum. Good sipping rum. For those who don't have a sweet tooth, and I put my rums on the sweeter side, it still works. I think you've been harsh to put a slice of lime. It's getting darker as we speak, so I'm looking at the screen, the monitor over here, and I can see that maybe the colour's a bit off balance now, so bear with me. This is all live, right? Okay. So before I give you the scores on the doors, please like, subscribe, and share the videos. Jump on the IG. If you were the IG, you would have seen recently details of Rumbash back in a couple weeks ago. You would see all my little updates when I'm going shopping, all that sort of thing. So the IG's definitely for the off the cuff, just spread among the stuff, and YouTube for the reviews. So with that said, what do I rate this rum? We've got buy and keep, buy and enjoy, aight, and I'm bad with it. This is not as good as a Princessa. However, it's still a good rum. So it's not gonna get buy and keep like the Princessa. But it's definitely getting a buy and enjoy. Definitely one City People's reasoning session, have a chinwag, go. Not one I'd say to be getting knocking back before a night out. But if you wanna have a few drinks, definitely recommend this Royal Oak.